Today we are studying a topic of solid geometry and our first topic is sphere. But before starting, some basic definitions or formulae. Number one, the distance between any two points whose coordinates are A and B, x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, as you know very well, it is under root of, you can learn this, then centroid of a triangle, it is given by this formula. Then direction cosines, alpha, beta, gamma, they are the angles made by the line with positive direction of x, y and z axis. Then these three angles, alpha, beta, gamma, they are called direction angles, and cosine of these three, that is cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, they are called direction cosines. Generally they are denoted by L, M and N. And a very important relation between these three is L square plus M square plus N square is 1. Then next is direction ratio. If L, M, N are the DCS and the number ABC are proportional to L, M, N, then these three numbers are called direction ratios. And here it is, first is the relation between L and L, M, N and ABC. Then we can find direction ratio of a line joining these two points by this formula. If theta is angle between two lines having DCS L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, N2, then we can find cosine of angle between these two lines. But suppose if we are given direction ratios, then also we can find the angle between that two lines. Then again, if the two lines are perpendicular, then we can use these two relations. Then plane. General equation of plane is given by this formula. Then next topic, the equation of any plane parallel to this plane is given by this equation. Just we have to change only constant. Then next is the equation of a plane which cuts off intercepts ABC on the coordinate axis. It is given by x by a plus y by b plus z by c equals to 1. Then perpendicular distance. By this formula, we can find perpendicular distance of a point from the plane. Then straight line. The equation of line passing through the point A, alpha, beta, gamma, and having DCS, LMN, it is given by this formula. Then equation of a line passing through two points, we can use this equation. Then again a very important result here. Suppose we have given equation of line, then we can find coordinates of any point on that line. Now start with a sphere. A sphere, as you know very well, a sphere is the locus of a point which moves in space so that its distance from a fixed point always remains constant. Fixed point is center and fixed distance is radius. There are different forms of sphere, equations of sphere. So let us see, first is called central form, or it is also called center radius form. So let us consider here a sphere having center at the point ABC and radius is R. Let us suppose that P is any point on the sphere. Just join this CP. So clearly CP will be R. Now by distance formula we can find CP. So number 1 and number 2 gives this equation. So it is our most general equation, that is center radius form of sphere. Then does the sphere whose center is point ABC and radius R is the set of this? We know that the following characteristics of equation of the sphere. आप लोग पहचान सकते हो इसको, ये स्फीयर का इक्वेशन है. नंबर वन, इट इज ए सेकेंड डिग्री इक्वेशन इन एक्स वाई जेड. देन नंबर टू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, द कोफिशियंट्स ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर, वाई स्क्वायर, जेड स्क्वायर, दे मस्ट बी ऑलवेज इक्वल. एंड नंबर थ्री, इट डज नॉट कंटेन द टर्म्स हैविंग द प्रोडक्ट लाइक एक्स वाई, वाई जेड एंड जेड. नाउ अगेन सी, इफ सपोज सेंटर इज ओरिजिन, so then above equation is reduced to x square plus y square plus z square equal to r square. It is our standard equation of sphere. Now, general form. So, for this, to prove that this equation represents a sphere with center at this point and radius is this. So, equation 1 can be written as just upon a deco transfer kiye right side mein and collect kar rahe term adding u square, v square, w square on both the side so that it becomes perfect square. Now, let us compare this with equation of sphere. So, it can be written in this form. Clearly compare these two. So, we will get here, hence equation 1 represents sphere. Compare these 2 and 3. Radius is given by this formula and radius is this here and center is this. Now, see example. Find the center and radii of the following sphere. Number 1. So, the general form is this. Now, compare these two equations. This equation and this equation. Let us compare this. So, here coefficient of x, it is twice u, it is 2. So, u is 1. Twice v, it is minus 4, v minus 2. Twice w, minus 6, w is minus 3. Constant term is 5. But center is given by minus u, minus v, minus w. So, it is minus 1, 2, 3. And radius under root of this formula. So, we can find radius. Now, second example. Yeah, actually problem ye hai ki x square, y square, z square ka coefficient 2 hai. Toh jab bhi aap logo ko center radius nikalna padega, always coefficient 1, 1, 1 lana hai. So, divide each by 2 and solve just like problem number 1. Now, next form is diameter form. Let us suppose that AX1, Y1, Z1 and BX2, Y2, Z2. They are the end point of a diameter. So, they are given point PX, Y, Z, B, any point. Just join AP and BP. So, since AB is a diameter, so angle APB will be 90 degree. So, by the formula, by the theorem, you know very well, angle in a semicircle is always a right angle. So, AP is perpendicular to BP. Now, DRS of AP. Now, just see coordinates of A and P. DRS of AP will be X minus X1, Y minus Y1, Z minus Z1 and similarly, direction ratio of BP. Now, AP is perpendicular to BP. So, we can write A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is always equal to 0. So, it is our equation of sphere in diameter form. Now, see this example. Diameter ke endpoint ke coordinates given hai. Wo bol raha hai ki find the equation of sphere. Just use this formula. So, these are x1, y1, z1. It is x2, y2, z2. Let us substitute values of all this. The equation will be x minus x1, x minus x2 plus y minus y1, y minus y2 plus z minus z1, z minus z2 equal to 0. Simplify this, you will get equation of sphere. So, let us stop here now.